Namaskar, Atul Gopal from Plug In India, and welcome to Chandigarh, where today we have Dr. Parvez with us and his beautiful Scott e-bike. So we're going to talk a little bit about Parvez and his e-bike now.
So I'm Dr. Mohammed Parvez. I'm a resident of Patiala, Punjab, and being a doctor, I am into these e-bikes, and because biking, I think, is the best solution to commute in a city from point A to point B. So my first e-bike was light speed drift, then I have a Firefox Adventron, which is a rear hub driven e-bike, and recently in the lockdown I got this Scott e-bike, which is a mid-drive system e-bike. It's got a Bosch operated system, and I've been using it around about, I think it's been 3 months, and I've driven around 1000 kilometers. It's a superb bike, and I do my daily commutes on it. My agenda is not into fitness or something. My agenda is to reduce my carbon imprint. So from point A to point B, I have to be on a mode which gives me least carbon imprint. And in that context, I figured out that e-bike are the best mode of transport in a city. Practically, I am running less than one unit for 130 kilometers. In the eco mode, obviously. So this is the Scott e-bike.
Let's see what this bike is all about. Okay. The most interesting part, like Parvez ji has told you, is that it comes with a mid-drive motor, and this is by Bosch, and Bosch is one of the best motor makers in the world. So we've been reviewing a lot of electric vehicles with Bosch motors, and we found all of them amazing. And even this one promises to be amazing. So mid-drive units are very well balanced for electric cycles, right? Because your center is located, your heavy weights are located all at the center. So the vehicle is much more easier to drive. There is a fairly big battery pack. It stores about 0.5 units of juice or 500 watt hours of energy. And that is enough for about 100 kilometers. And like Parvez was telling you, 100 kilometers at 500 watt hours is the best that you can get in the electric vehicle world, right? So as far as energy efficiency is concerned, there's nothing which can beat electric cycles. So most of our cycles that we've been reviewing have had hub motors behind. There are a few kits like E-ADIC which have had hub motors in the front, but this baby over here has got a mid-drive motor. There is a Hero Electro model also available with a mid-drive. But there are not too many mid-drives in the market simply because they are expensive. Okay, let's move on. Hydraulic disc brakes in front and rear. And what I liked again is that Parvez has gone on and he's also got a kind of display or computer, if you want to call it, which is also with Bosch. Now don't ask me what the cost is. We'll ask that to him later on, right? So overall, it's a very good quality of build. The cycling ride quality has also been fantastic. Suspension is quite okay, right? So one more interesting thing about mid-drive motors and Bosch motors to some extent is that normally you've got sensors which are motion based. So the pedal assist is based on a motion sensor. So there are magnets which are attached to the pedaling shaft, and that picks up whether the cycle is kind of, you know, in motion or not, the pedal is in motion or not. But with Bosch, so you have to push some torque from your end for the motor to push. So there's a minimum amount of torque that you have always to give to the motor, right? So that's kind of a plus and a minus. But if you are a cyclist, you would want to exert some torque. Otherwise, you might as well have bought Ather in the same money that you buy this. But we'll kind of stick to that, come to that later. The brakes are both hydraulic. So you can see the cylinder over here for the hydraulic fluid, Shimano brakes both places. So the other interesting thing about the bike is the meter, right? So this is a Bosch meter, goes very well with the Bosch system. It was not a purchased accessory. So you press by switching this particular button on, and here you can see the odometer reading 1137. It's a single color display, but the use of black and white has been very good. And you can see this is the trip distance, you have a trip meter, your clock, maximum speed 58 kilometers. Wow, Parvez, you've been going places. Okay, average speed is 23, trip time so far 33 hours, range. Now this is interesting. Now the range is showing as 159 kilometers. So note that this is a distance to empty. Most of the meters that we've been looking at in normal this thing are giving you range in terms of percentage by the number of bars or an actual percentage value. But this is a system where, like our Mahindra E2O cars, it's actually giving you a distance to empty, which is an amazing thing. And I'll show you something interesting now. So as we change the mode, now this is, note kijiye, eco mode mein hai, correct? The moment I make it into tour mode, the range goes down to 99. If I make it to sport, 87, and if I make it to turbo, it's 78. So the range depends on what mode you are in. Okay, these are all different levels of assist, right? But I believe that this is as high tech as BMSs can get as far as cycles are concerned. So I think this is an amazing feature of the particular cycle. So this is your Bosch integrated mid-drive motor, correct? So it's got a motor and a gear reduction inside. Now there's only one sprocket at the front, not 2-3, and what I found interesting is the sprocket size is pretty small, and you have almost what, 10 gears behind?
11
gears behind. So you got a big range. So from a climbing point of view, this gear is going to be useful, right? And another interesting thing about Parvez is the heavy duty lock he's got for this very super expensive cycle. So I believe weighs as much as it costs, right? So it almost is 2.5 kg in terms of weight.
So this is the AXA lock which comes with this e-bike. So you just have to put in here, and you have to just press it, and it just pops out.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, one second, can you talk a little bit about the battery? If you can just show us the connectors and...
Yeah, so this is the here you have this three-point charging system. Here, okay. These are the indicators once you start to charge the battery. Okay. Yeah, it takes around about 4 hours to charge from 0 to 100, like full discharge, 4 hours.
Okay.
Yeah.
And this is 500 watt hours.
Yeah.
Battery. How much does it weigh, Parvez?
I think it's 2.5 kgs.
2.5?
Yeah.
That's kind of fairly heavy.
Yeah.
Right. So this is the battery compartment, guys. So there's a slot inside. So it's good for aesthetics, and it, the battery fits in snugly. So let's see Parvez fitting the battery back.
Yeah. That's done.
Okay. So, Parvezji, what are the kind of things that you would like improved in this bike? So, are there any improvement areas that you would like to suggest the manufacturers?
First of all, I think the improvement part in this e-bike should be on the weight. I think it weighs about 24 kgs.
Okay.
So, it should be, I think, around about 18-19. That would be the ideal weight for an e-bike. Maybe it's just because of the design or something. Other thing is which I would talk about the gears, like SRAM gears. It takes time to like adjust to them.
Okay. So
like,
can you just tell me a little bit about how the gears ups and downs are?
So this is the down one. This is the up one.
Okay.
So
you have to push the up one. Normally so you have to pull it in.
Exactly.
A lot of the Shimano.
So you
gears.
Sometimes you the first time user already struggle with it.
Okay.
In gradual course of time, you tend to use with you can get to use with that this system. Other thing aesthetics like these. like this welding point, sometimes you feel that for a e-bike of this cost, it should have been better.
So let's come to the most sensitive question.
Yeah.
How much did it cost you?
It costed me 1,89,000.
Wow.
It's on the higher side, but
Is without accessories?
Yeah, without accessories.
And you spent how much on accessories?
Accessories, I think I got the display. It should have been 10 to 12,000, the Intovia display.
Okay.
And the Lupine integrated light.
Okay.
It was also of that range, maybe more, I think, because I don't remember the exact cost with that. It should have come with integrated lights along with the mudguards, I think, because once you're spending 189, the company should have included this. And maybe because it's EMTB, that's why they didn't include the mudguard, but it should have been there.
Right. So, Parvez, some final comments about electric bikes in general. Who would you recommend electric bikes for?
Generally, I used to say that e-bikes are for those kids who are not eligible for a driving license.
Okay.
It's a very good thing. It adds so that maybe if you can, for the kids, you don't want to give them many expensive bike, but you can give them electro or those kind of bikes. Discuss usually for older people with medical conditions, like kisi ka knee joint ka problem hai, kisi ko lagta hai ki main nahi, I can't drive that cycle, that conventional cycle. So these motors help you down that. So it will make you active into your mid 50s or maybe into your 60s. For those people, it's a perfect solution. And otherwise, if you want to reduce your carbon imprint from and driving into a city from point A to point B, I think e-bikes are the best mode of transport. This is yeah.
Friends, with that we come to the end of the small interaction that we had with Dr. Parvez, and I think the hint that he has given towards the end is for people like me, right? Ki aapke budhape ka sahara mid-drive electric motors hona chahiye, right? So I believe that the way ahead for electric cycles is going to be mid-drive, right? Maybe price points need to come down. Couple of lakhs, a lot of people would want to say, "Arey, ether ke dam mein cycle bech rahe ho," right? So I guess that prices will come down over time, hopefully with Indian manufacturers coming in, right? So maybe it will be a good value for money somewhere between the 50,000 to 1 lakh territory, right? And I hope we have manufacturers who come with that. So that's all for today. Thank you very much. Take care.